Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah, Quran Weekly. This is Abdul Nasser Jengda coming to you with another installment of Stories of the Prophets. Today we're going to be talking about the Prophet of Allah, Muhammadur Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When the Prophet ﷺ first received divine inspiration and revelation, and then he was entrusted with the task of sharing and spreading this message to all of mankind and all of humanity, the Prophet ﷺ started exerting himself to his full capacity, going 100% and giving everything that he had to sharing and spreading and teaching this message of Islam. At the same time, another thing you have to actually understand is that there are a lot of narrations which talk about the fact that when the Prophet ﷺ would receive divine revelation, these are the words of God, these are the words of Allah, Kalamullah, the Quran, that is being revealed to him as a human being. It was very heavy on him, and it was actually a lot of times It was something that exhausted him. It would fatigue him. It was very, very difficult at times to receive that divine revelation. And so some of the narrations mention that either due to receiving that divine revelation consistently for some time, or secondly, now on top of that, he's going around and preaching and teaching the message and starting to deal with a lot of the backlash, the refusal and the denial and the accusations from some of his opponents in Mecca. And then on top of that, you know, just in the course of everyday life, the Prophet ﷺ became ill. He got sick for a couple of days. And so he didn't wake up in the night, he wasn't able to, you know, pray his qiyam prayers. And some of the narrations mention that because he was already physically ill and sick, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not send him revelation there for a couple of days to allow him to physically recover so that he would be able to better his health and then start receiving that divine revelation again. During those couple of days that he did not receive divine revelation, a woman comes to him, and some of the narrations mention that this was the wife of Abu Lahab, the same woman that's mentioned in Surah Lahab. Tabbat yada abi lahabin wa tab wa imra'atuhu hammalat al-hatab. That woman that's mentioned in the Surah of Abu Lahab, that woman, the wife of Abu Lahab, she comes to the Prophet ﷺ and she says that, "I see that you're shaitan." All right, she's using this word sarcastically. "I see that this shaitan, this Satan, this demon that has possessed you," وَلَعِيَاذُ بِاللَّهِ أَسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهِ, "this demon that has possessed you has left you. He hasn't come to you for a couple of days." And she started taunting and mocking the Prophet ﷺ in this way. And the Prophet ﷺ, of course, didn't pay any attention to her. He wasn't affected by her. But at the same time, the Prophet ﷺ himself had developed such an attachment and such a longing for receiving the words of Allah, the Kalamullah, the Quran, the divine revelation, and then reading and reciting it within his prayer, that the Prophet ﷺ himself started to miss it and long for it as well. So during when she comes and she starts taunting and making fun of the Prophet ﷺ at that particular time, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent down surah number 93. What did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say? Wadduha. Duha is what you call the mid-morning, when the sun has fully risen and it's midday, mid-morning, that time when the sun is brilliant. And you know, it's like 9 a.m., 10 a.m. It's sometimes the best weather of the entire day, where the sun is up, it's light and it's bright outside, and the trees and the leaves and the flowers, everything is in full bloom, the birds are flying, it's not too hot, the coolness of the night and the early morning has passed as well, and you can get a little bit of sun. It's just a beautiful, beautiful time of the day, that 9-10 a.m. time of the morning. وَالْضُحَى, that the sun has risen, the light has spread. وَاللَّيْلِ إِذَا سَجَى, Allah swears by that time of duha, mid-morning, and then Allah swears by the night when it fully sets in and everything becomes calm and quiet and still during the night. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, مَا وَدَّعَكَ رَبُّكَ وَمَا قَلَى, your Lord has not abandoned you, nor is your Lord upset or angry with you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sends the divine. This is the beauty of this surah. Not only does Allah send the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam divine revelation, alleviating therefore his concern and whatever worries he has. But at the same time, the revelation that Allah sends the Prophet ﷺ, that revelation itself says what? Your Lord has not abandoned you. Your Lord is not upset with you. Don't listen to these people. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells the Prophet ﷺ, وَلَلْآخِرَةُ خَيْرٌ لَكَ مِنَ الْأُولَىٰ. And most definitely, without a doubt, the hereafter will be better for you than this first life of this world. There's a remarkable story where the Prophet ﷺ, Abdullah bin Mas'ud says, the Prophet ﷺ laid down on the ground one time and there were pebbles. When he sat up, it left the mark of the pebbles on his body, on his side. And he says, I started to rub the side of the Prophet ﷺ to kind of like, remove some of those pebbles and those markings on his skin. And I said, O Messenger of Allah, please give us permission. We'll come and put something soft on the ground for you so you can lie down on it. And the Prophet ﷺ says, مَا لِي وَلِلدُّنْيَا. Why would I care anything at all about the dunya? The Prophet ﷺ said, my only relationship with the dunya is like somebody who was traveling and he stopped under the shade of a tree and he sat down and he took a little bit of a break, he took a little bit of a breather, and then he got up and he moved on. That's the dunya and me. وَلَسَوْفَ يُعْطِيكَ رَبُّكَ فَتَرْضَى. And very soon enough, your Lord will give to you, your master, your Lord will deliver to you, will give to you that which will please you. That which will bring you true happiness in this life and in the next. And the narrations also mention about that, that when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam that your ummah will be forgiven and your ummah will be blessed and your ummah will be the first of the followers and the nations to enter into paradise and Allah will multiply their good deeds and forgive their sins, that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, this brought so much joy to his heart. وَلَسَوْفَ يُعْطِيكَ رَبُّكَ فَتَرْضَى. Soon enough your Lord and your master will give to you, and that will bring you such happiness more than anything this world can ever provide. So this is a beautiful story about the life of the Prophet ﷺ, connected to Surah number 93, Surah Wadduha. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us all the ability to practice everything that was said and heard. SubhanAllah wa bihamdihi, subhanakallah wa bihamdik, jazakumullah khairan. Quran Weekly for watching. Remember to hit the subscribe button if you haven't yet. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu.